to $2 billion a year on corrections. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Pamela DeLissio. Thanks for being with us.
Pleasure to be here.
When we talk about $1.9 billion as part of the budget, it's close to 7% of the overall state budget. But what does that mean in terms of our tax dollars? Where is that money going?
Well, that money is going to support primarily our prison systems, Fisk plant to operate those prisons, the upkeep for those prisons, and as well as all the expenses affiliated with housing prisoners. Those expenses on an annualized basis are roughly $33,000 to $34,000 a year to house a prisoner.
That's per individual prisoner.
Per individual prisoner, that's correct.
Now, let's talk a little bit about the taxpayer dollars and how they are used. You mentioned per individual prisoner, it's around $33,500 per year. That's per individual.
Yep.
But you say there's a direct impact from the legislature and the laws that are made on an annual basis related to mandatory minimum sentencing. Give us an idea as to your thoughts on that and why you say there's a correlation there.
Well, lately we're seeing legislation come through where the House of Representatives is mandating increasing the mandated minimum sentence. And I have two concerns about that. One is that's the role of a judge. The judge has the job to decide, based on their sentencing guidelines, what a sentence should be for an individual case. Lots of variables in any case. The judge gets to consider those variables and decide where within that sentencing guideline is most appropriate. If the legislature continues to state what the minimum mandated sentence is, for instance, if the judge's guideline is currently 5 to 7 years, and the legislature says, no, we want this particular crime to have a minimum of at least 7 years, then those two additional years that we're mandating will cost the taxpayers over almost $70,000 more, because the legislature has made a decision to do that. We are also making decisions that misdemeanors, which are a lesser offense than felonies, we're increasing things from a misdemeanor to a felony. And those carry increased sentences. Increased sentences mean it costs more money to house those prisoners. And we need to look at what we can do to keep folks out of prison.
Could this, though, act as a deterrent to crime?
In my own humble opinion, no. I don't think the criminal on the street is stopping to think that, oh my God, the legislature just made this crime a felony last week instead of a misdemeanor, so I'm not going to do it. That's not the nature of how that works.
Are there steps then that could be taken to act more proactively when it comes to crime reduction and then in turn reduction in the costs of corrections?
Absolutely. We need to be proactive, and proactive means to make sure folks have an education, that they have job skills and appropriate training, and that we're endeavoring to drive the economy to create the jobs whereby they'll have a sustainable living wage. In Pennsylvania, interestingly enough, I just learned that we don't mandate that a child even go to school to 8 years of age. I mean, we should be mandating, and we don't, full-day kindergarten. So the sooner folks get into an educational system and learn, the better off they'll be for the rest of their life, and we don't do that in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
In addition to education, let's talk a little bit about once a person may be eligible for parole and they work to get out of the prison system, what about on the back end of this? Are there steps that can be taken there?
I'm always learning in this job, and I learned recently that when somebody applies for parole, they're up for parole, they need to submit a $60 application fee to the parole board in order for their hearing to happen. I've also learned that there are instances, albeit not many, but there are definitely instances where prisoners don't have the $60, so they continue to stay in our prisons at an average cost of $600 to $700 a week until they can come up with the $60 for their parole hearing. I think that's a little concerning.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Pamela DeLissio. I'm Jill Horner.